Dear students, in today's lecture we will study division by 9, 2-digit and 3-digit numbers, right? Now, in our previous lectures we have already studied the division by 5, division by 25, multiplication by 5, multiplication by 25. These simple tricks we already learned. In continuation of that, today we will learn division by 9, right? So before going to start the lecture, please subscribe the YouTube channel if you are not subscribed yet. Okay, so in this lecture we will be studying how division by 9 to 48, what is the answer in short, right? Similarly, 97 by 9, okay, you may get the recurring decimals here. So how to find those recurring decimals, okay, and quotient and remainders after division by 9. 342 divided by 9, that is 3-digit number. 602 divided by 9, that is 3-digit number, right? So can we start here division by 9 with 2-digit numbers? Is that clear? So let us see first example. Divide the number 34 by 9, right? Divide the number 34 by 9. Okay, so what we do here, we have to look at here. Here this 34 is what? This 34 is dividend. Dividend. And what is 9? 9 is divisor. Is that clear? So divide the dividend into left hand part and right hand part. Right. So left hand, from left hand part we will get the quotient, and from right hand part we will get the remainder. Is that clear? So, is that clear? So we can divide here, look, 34. So we divide here 3, 4, and we are dividing by 9. 34 divided into two parts. Is that clear? So draw the line. After leaving some space below. Okay. So now we write this 3 under 3. Is that clear? Is that clear? So put the first digit of the dividend under the horizontal line. Is that clear? So then why, okay, so look at here, we did the first, we divided into two parts, we here put the horizontal line below that, and then we write the first digit below under the horizontal line. Okay, now this first digit which we wrote under the horizontal line, okay, this digit to put here as plus 3. Okay, and now 4 plus 3 is what? 7. Is that clear? And thus 34 divided by 9 gives us 3. Right, as a quotient and remainder 7 as a remainder. Is that clear? So this is what Q and this is what remainder. Is that clear? So Similarly, we can solve the various examples like this. So look at here. We divide 62 divided by 9, and now divide in two parts. We are dividing by 9. Draw the line here and we write 6 here, and we put this 6 plus 6. Is that clear? And now 6 plus 2 is 8. Okay, and therefore, is that clear? Therefore, quotient is equal to 6 and remainder is equal to 8. Is that clear? Then another example. Look at here. 74 divided into two parts. So we write here and we are dividing by 9. So draw the horizontal line. Then we write 7 below 7. And now this 7 is plus 7. Okay. Now 4 plus 7 is 11. 4 plus 7 is 11. Right here. Now what we will get? We write here minus 9 and plus 1. Why? Because 11 is divisible by 9. Remainder is greater than the divisor. And therefore, what we have here? Look at here. 7 plus 1 is 8 and 11 minus 9 is 2. And thus, quotient is equal to 8. And remainder is equal to 2. Is that clear? Then next example. 97 by, so again 97. Is that clear? Divide. Now we are dividing by 9, so write down 9 below 9. Now add this 9 here. So here you will get 9 plus 7 is 16. Okay, but 16 is again greater than 9. So we write minus 9 and here is what? Plus 1. So we have 10 and here is 16 minus 9 is 7. And therefore quotient is equal to 10 and remainder is equal to 7. Is that clear? Then similarly, next example, 48 by 9. So what we get? 48 divided by 9. So we divide into two parts, draw horizontal line, write down 4 under 4. Then 4, add this 4 here, so it is 12. Now again 12 is greater than this 9, okay, and therefore we do minus 9 and plus 1. Okay, so what we have here? 4 plus 1, 5, and 12 minus 9 is 3, and so quotient is equal to 5 and remainder is equal to 3. Is that clear? Okay. So now next example. Here look at here 88. Right. Now divide by 9. So we write 8 below 8. Now we write here, add 8 here. So 8 plus 8 is 16, which is greater than 9. So minus 9 plus 1 here. Okay. So what we have? 16 minus 9 is 7 and 8 plus 1 is 9. And therefore, quotient is equal to 9 and remainder is equal to 7. Is that clear? Okay. Then what we will get? Now we try to do it fast, right? So we divide by 9. So write 9 below 9 plus 9 here. Okay, 4 plus 9, 13. 13 greater than 9. and therefore minus 9 plus 1 here. Okay, so what we have, 10, and here is 13 minus 9 is 4. So quotient is equal to 10, remainder is equal to 4. Is that clear? Then next example, 68 divided by 9. Divide into two part. Write 6 below 6. Then add this 6 here. Okay. So 8 plus 6, 14. 14 is greater than 9. And therefore minus 9 is equal to 5. So minus 9 is done here. So it is plus 1. So it is what? 7. Okay. And therefore quotient is equal to 7. Remainder is equal to 5. Is that clear? Then 51 by 9. Is that clear? So look at here, 51 by 9. We write the horizontal line here. So write down 5 below 5. Now add this 5 here. Okay, 5 plus 1, 6. Now this 6 is what? Smaller than 9. So it is a quotient. This is a quotient. And this is quotient and this is what? Remainder. So quotient is equal to 5 and remainder is equal to 6. Is that clear? Now we did what we have seen here, division by 9 to 2 digit number. Now we see division by 9 to 3 digit numbers. Okay, so again we explain this with the help of example. Look at here. Divide the number 521 by 9. Is that clear? So look at here. 521. So first step is what? Draw vertical line before the unit digit. Which is unit digit? 521. Unit digit is this. So draw vertical line. Is that clear? Then, okay, and we divide by 9. Is that clear? Draw horizontal line here. Okay, so leave some place below and draw horizontal line. Is that clear? Then what we do? Put the first digit of the dividend from left as it is under horizontal line. So we write here 5. Okay, we add this 5 here. So this is what? 7. Is that clear? And we add this 7 here. So it is 8. And this 8 is smaller than 9. And therefore, is that clear? So what is quotient now? Quotient is equal to 57. And what is remainder? Remainder is equal to 8. Is that clear? It is very simple. So understand, how we started, we write this 5 below 5, this 5, then add this 5 here, then 2 plus 5, 7, then add this 7 here, 1 plus 7, 8, 8 is smaller, so it is quotient, remainder. And this 57 is what? 57 is a quotient. Is that clear? So, example 2. Is that clear? So, same method we have to follow here. So, what do you do? 3, 4, 2, dividing by 9. Put the vertical line before unit digit. Draw horizontal line. Now, write 3. Below 3, add this 3 here, so it is 7. Okay, and add this 7 here, so it is what? 9. Is that clear? So this 3, this 7, isn't it? But look at here, okay, so 9 is equal to this 9, so subtract 9. add 1. So what we have here, 38, 0. So what is quotient? 38, remainder 0. Is that clear? Okay. Then another example, 602. Same way, 602. Draw vertical line, divide by 9. Draw horizontal line. Now write down 6 here. Now add this 6 here. Okay, so 6. Okay, add this 6 here. It is 8, and this 8 is smaller than 9, and therefore this is what? Quotient. Quotient is equal, sorry, quotient, remainder. Remainder is equal to 8, and quotient is equal to how much? 66. This is quotient. Is that clear? This is quotient, and this is what? Remainder. Okay, now next example. 512 divided by 9. Draw horizontal line before unit digit. So now write down 5 below 5. Add 5 here. So it is 6. Add 6 here. So it is 8. Okay, and this 8 is smaller, and therefore quotient is equal to 56. Remainder is equal to 8. Is that clear? Then next example, 341 divided by 9. Draw horizontal vertical line. Now write down 3 below 3. Add this 3 here. Okay, this 7. Add this 7 here. This is what? 8. This 8 is smaller again, and therefore this 8 is what? Remainder is equal to 8, and quotient is equal to what? 37. Is that clear? So this is what? Quotient, this is remainder. Is that clear? Then 823 divided by 9. Okay, 823 vertical line. Horizontal line divided by 9. Okay, now write 8 below 8. Add this 8 here. That is 10. Is that clear? This is 10. Now what we do here? We subtract minus 9 here. Okay, and plus 1 here, because 10 is greater than 9, and so we have 9, and here is what? 1, and we add this 1 here, plus 1, so it is 4. So this is what? Quotient, and this is what? Remainder, and this is a quotient. So Q is equal to 91. And R is equal to 4. Is that clear? Now, next example. 517 divided by 9. Draw vertical line, then horizontal line. Write 5 below 5. Put 5 here. Add 6. Put 6 here, that is what? 13. Is that clear? Now look at here. 13 is greater than 9, so we subtract 9, add plus 1 here. So what we have here? 57, and here 13 minus 9 is 4, and so therefore quotient is equal to 57, remainder is equal to 4. Is that clear? Okay. Then Next example, 605 divided by 9. 605 divided by 9. Put horizontal vertical line, then horizontal line. Write 6 below 6. Then add this 6 here. 0 plus 6 is 6. Add this 6 here. 5 plus 6, 11. But you know, this is remainder greater than 9. And therefore minus 9. And here is what? Plus 1. So what? 66 plus 1? 67. And here is 11 minus 9 is 2. And therefore, quotient is equal to 67. Remainder is equal to 2. Is that clear? Then another example. 243 divided by 9. Okay. 243 divided by 9. Put vertical line, then horizontal line. Put 2 below 2 under horizontal line. Now add these 2 here. 4 plus 2, 6. Add this 6 here. 6 plus 3, 9. But you again see that this 9 and 9 equal. Therefore subtract 9. Add 1 here. And therefore we have 26 plus 1 is 27. 9 minus 9 is 0. And therefore quotient is equal to 27. Remainder is equal to 0. Is that clear? So in this way we have seen the examples on division by 9 to 2 digit numbers and 3 digit number. Is that clear? So if you like this lecture, please subscribe. Is that clear? Share it to the students studying in 8th standard or 8th high school level. Like lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.